Good morning, children. Now this is 6th class social studies. Now we are in the 4th lesson of this social studies. What is that lesson name? Landforms of Andhra Pradesh. Landforms of Andhra Pradesh. In that, I said in the previous class, what are the main landforms? For example, what are the relief features of India? In India, one of the state is our Andhra Pradesh. Mountains are there. Plains are there, plateaus are there, etc. Now, children, I want to explain to you about plains in our Andhra Pradesh. Not only Andhra Pradesh, so we know the one of the most relief feature of our India, Indo-Gangetic Plains. What are that? Indo-Gangetic Plains. So, these plains formed by fertile land. That means with alluvial soil, which is brought by the river water, flood water. Okay. Likewise, in the plain, the landform is height or elevation is from the sea level just 200 meters. It is very fertile land. For example, Indo-Gangetic Plains. Not only Indo-Gangetic Plains, but also Eastern Plains and Western Plains also there, especially in peninsular India. Okay. That means in South India. So one of the part is our Andhra Pradesh coastal region. Okay. Now listen, students. So if you carefully observe, these plains are very dense population. Why? Because the land is fertile land. So many crops are growing here. Water also available. So that is why people living more than compared with plateaus and mountains regions. Now children, next one, for example, Andhra Pradesh, it is only one of the state in India. How many states are there according to your textbook? 29 states are there in India. Among them, Andhra Pradesh is one of the one. So, this Andhra Pradesh has a coastline 972 kilometers. How many kilometers? 972 kilometers. The area size is 7th place, occupied to 7th place in the remaining states in India. Next one, it occupies 10th place in population. It is very populous state. It occupies 10th place. So now listen, students, the coastal length of Andhra Pradesh is 972 kilometers. The size is 7th place occupied, and population wisely it occupies 10th place. So now children, we know in the previous lesson I said about the boundaries of our Andhra Pradesh. For example, if it is Andhra Pradesh, okay, so this is Bay of Bengal. This is Bay of Bengal. That means this is the coastal line. This is the coastal line. The land which connects with water body is called coastal line. So how many kilometers the coastal line of Andhra Pradesh? 972 kilometers. So here the coastal districts, we know 9 districts are there. How many districts are there? 9 districts. I read to you: Srikakulam, Vijayanagaram, Visakhapatnam, East Godavari, West Godavari, Krishna, Prakasham, Guntur, Prakash, Nellore. Okay, so these are the 9 districts. I repeat, Krishna, Guntoru, Srikakulam, Vijayanagaram, Visakhapatnam, East Godavari, West Godavari, Krishna, Guntoru, Prakasham, Nellore. So these are the 9 districts, coastal area districts in Andhra Pradesh. Next one, children, look at the coastal area. How many? 9 districts are there. So many deltas are also there here in these districts. Why? Because two main important rivers are flowing. What are the rivers? Krishna River, Godavari River. These rivers form deltas. Okay, delta. So that is why this land is very fertile land. So even the population also very dense population living here. Krishna Godavari River basin. That means I think this is. Here you can find the Krishna River and you can find the Godavari River. Next one, what about Rayalaseema? So Rayalaseema four districts are there. Anantapuram, Chittoor, Kadapa, Karnoolu, these are the four Rayalaseema districts. Actually, these districts are hilly or rocky area. So, it is not a fertile land. Even the rivers also, water facilities also very scarce in this area. So, that's why cultivated land is less than compared with coastal area. But horticulture is developing in this area. Horticulture. So, next one. Eastern Ghats also there. So, what are the Eastern Ghats? Look at children, these are Eastern Ghats in our state. Okay, they are not continuous one like Western Ghats. So, they are Eastern Ghats. Next, Deccan Plateau is there. So, this is Deccan Plateau. Next one, hills and plains also there. So, many hills are there. Yarmala Hills, Nalmala Hills. Okay, many hills are there. So, plains means this is all area is called plains, plain area. This is eastern coastal plains. Eastern coastal plains. So, children, now that is the physical or landforms of our Andhra Pradesh. So, in Andhra Pradesh also we can find hills, we can find plains, we can find okay, plateau. What is that plateau? Deccan Plateau is the part of Andhra Pradesh. Next children, mountains, hills. What place is called mountains or hills? From sea level, that means mean sea level, if the place height is or elevation is 900 meters above, that is called hills. For example, in Andhra Pradesh, YSR Kadapa district, East Godavari and West Godavari, we can find many hills. Not only these three or four districts, even Visakhapatnam also we can find hills. Chittooru, Karnoolu, Vijayanagaram. So these are the hills areas or districts of our Andhra Pradesh. So how many districts are there near hills areas? Vijayanagaram, Karnoolu, Chittooru, Visakhapatnam, East Godavari, West Godavari, Kadapa and Kadapa. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 districts are there. Okay, next one. Among the highest peak we can find, that height is 690 meters from the sea level. That highest peak name is in this area, Armakonda or Aroya Konda. What is that? Near Chintapalli you can find Aroya Konda. Okay, Aroya Konda. So, Araku Valley, near Araku Valley, it is very famous. Next one, how these hills formed? With two kinds of rocks, condylites and charmokites. So, these are the rocky area. What is that? It color is reddish color or light brown color. Next one, Borra Caves in Visakhapatnam, they are very famous in this area. Papikondalu, East Godavari and West Godavari region. Papikondalu also, it is very famous tourist place or spot. Okay, next children, in our Andhra Pradesh, one place in winter season recording low temperature. Okay, that place is called Lambasingi. What that place? Lambasingi. Now children, it is also known as Kashmir of Andhra Pradesh. What is the Kashmir of Andhra Pradesh? Lambasingi. Lambasingi is the Kashmir of Andhra Pradesh in Visakhapatnam area or around this mountain region. So Lambasingi is considered or called as Kashmir of Andhra Pradesh. Now the land or that mountain region or hills area formed by red. Its color is red and rocky. Next one, plantation. Crops are not growing abundantly here, but plantations is important. We know what are the plantations, etc. Beverage crops also growing here. What are the beverage crops? Coffee and tea. These are the beverage crops. Coffee and tea. Next in this lesson, children, podu, the cultivation of podu. It is one of the old or ancient method cultivation which is done by our ancestors. Okay, so what is the method in this food agriculture? So the people who are living in forest area or hilly area or agencies area, they will cut off the trees. Okay, after cutting the trees, they started ploughing in that certain area. They will raise the crops 1 or 2 or some years in the same land. Okay, after they will left this area and they will go to another area. Again, they will start to cutting the trees and cultivate the land in some years or 1 or 2 or 3 years. So this system is called podu cultivation. In this podu cultivation, what crops are rising there, growing here? Jowar, maize are important crops in this one. Actually, who are living in these mountains and hilly areas, especially in Andhra Pradesh, they have a huge yard behind their houses. In that huge yard, okay, they will fence with bamboo trees or sticks. Okay, they are fencing with bamboo sticks because bamboo is available there. So that's why they are constructing one type of fencing. Inside of the yard, they are growing some kinds of vegetables and also fruit, etc. So throughout the year they are cultivating in the house only, that means back of their houses only. So they are surviving like that. Okay, that is called kitchen yards or kitchen gardens. What is that? Kitchen gardens. So in the kitchen gardens they are cultivating or growing some kinds of vegetables. Okay, we know what are the vegetables. If you go to Rait Bazaar, then you can find what are the vegetables daily cooking by our mom and our family members. Next, some kinds of fruits also they are growing in the kitchen yards. Okay, our kitchen gardens. Children, actually in these hilly areas, we cannot find any river flowing because that is a high place. Okay, next one, we cannot to dig any wells. So people who are living there, they are taking the water. What are the natural streams are there? From that natural streams and a few water resources are there. With that water resources, they are living and they are cultivating their lands. So that is the surviving process of these hilly areas who are living. Next one, Chenchu. Chenchu is one of the tribal in our Andhra Pradesh. It is ancient tribal, even though they are living in the two forest areas. So for example, we can find these Chenchu people in Kurnool, Guntur, Prakasham districts. Kurnool, Guntur, Prakasham districts. Their main activity is hunting animals in the forest areas. So, but they are starting agriculture activities also. The government of Andhra Pradesh, they recognized by government of Andhra Pradesh. Even the government to set up schools also for their education. Next, they gave loans, that means government giving encouragement to the Chenchu people because they are the tribal people in that three districts. So ITDA, so the government set up one organization that is called ITDA in 1918 from Srikakulam as headquarter. So with that headquarter, they will take what are their essential things or some aid from the government, from this ITDA. Now children, so this is about plains and hills or mountain region of our Andhra Pradesh. So we know what are the boundaries of Andhra Pradesh. Now children, I want to show you some pictures about this lesson. Children, look at this one. So I said this is the coastal area. I already drawn on the blackboard. This is the coastal area. What are the coastal districts here? I already told you 9 districts. So Srikakulam, Vijayanagaram, Visakhapatnam, East Godavari, West Godavari, Krishna, Guntur, Prakasham, Nellur, etc. Okay, these are the Rayalaseema districts. So what are that? Kurnool, Anantapuram, Kadapa and Chittoor. YSR Kadapa and Chittoor. Okay. Now these are the borders of our Andhra Pradesh. Here Karnataka, this is Maharashtra, this is Chhattisgarh, Odisha, Bay of Bengal East, south part is
Tamil Nadu west to Karnataka. Okay, now turn your pages. The relief features I said about hills. Okay, now these are the hills. Okay, next two rivers. I said to you two rivers, Krishna River and Godavari River. Okay, so this is plains area. Look, this is plains area. So in this plain area, people are dense population living there because they are rearing animals and also they cultivated the fertile land. So they are producing abundant yield of the production from their fields, etc. Okay, children, now look at, I want to read to you, this is, how many hills are there, what are the districts? For example, Visakhapatnam, we can find Arada, Anantagiri Hills. East and West Godavari, Bisan Hills and Papikondalu, we can find. Krishna district, we are leaving Mogalrajpuram Hills and Kondapalli Hills. Next, Guntur, Berum Konda and Nagarjun Konda, Kotappa Konda. YSR Kadapa, SPSR Nellore, Velikondalu, Karnulu, Nalamala, Ermala, YSR Kadapa, Velikondalu, Palakondalu, Chitturu, Seshasalam and Harsley Hills, Ananthapuram, Penugonda and Madaka, Sira Hills are there. So they are the main hills and the districts of our Andhra Pradesh. Now students, once again look this picture. This is natural spring. Who are living around these hilly areas? The people are taking their essential water for drinking purpose and also for animals, from natural springs which are flowing from the valleys of their hilly areas and mountain regions. Okay, children, I shall explain to you the remaining lesson in the next class. Thank you.